Environmental groups maintain green initiatives and, looking after the environment is a key issue in the 2013 national elections. Now, this year, environmental groups have again come together to push their green electoral initiative into the Senate halls. Aside from urging candidates to put a premium on environmental protection, they also hope voters will factor in green consciousness into making their choice. Now, here to tell us more about their campaign is Beau Bacongis from the program manager of Greenpeace Southeast Asia. Good morning, Beau.
Good morning, Paolo.
All right, the Green Electoral Initiative, or the GEI, tell us a little bit more about it.
GEI is an initiative that we do every election since 2007.
Right.
You know? And it's looking at the environmental platforms of the candidates, particularly those in the national, running for national positions. Mm-hmm. So this year we launched Verde Kaba,
right,
to ask the senatorial candidates their about their platforms on the environment and look at their track records.
Right. Now, it was initiated in 2007. Mm-hmm. You know, there's been a couple of elections since then.
Yes.
What's the response been? How have the candidates sort of responded to is it a survey? Are we calling it a survey?
Yes. We have different activities surrounding mm-hmm. This initiative.
Lead one.
That a lot of candidates were serious
right.
about looking at
the
environment.
That's a bit disappointing, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm. Considering the situation we are now,
right.
We see the urgency of environmental mm-hmm. issues. We have climate change impacts already upon us, and yet we do not see it as a priority,
right.
Especially for the elections.
All right. More and more people really are interested in or being involved really in greener consciousness. And I understand that a voter education campaign was launched in February to really help educate voters, for lack of a better word, on how important it really is to put a green agenda at the forefront when you choose which candidates you are going to vote for.
Right. What we did was get people involved, especially in social media.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So in our Facebook and Twitter mm-hmm. Pages, we encourage people to get their candidates or people they think are their candidates, that mm-hmm. people that they will be voting for, to participate. And they themselves can ask their candidates
yeah.
what their position is on certain
right.
environmental issues.
And really, voters really should be asking, you know, what the stand of the candidates are on these important issues. The fact that it was like you said, a little disappointing that only was it six?
Yes, we only got six candidates.
Actually, took the opportunity to lay out their green agenda, if that's what we're calling it. Is the fact that they've answered your survey already a thumbs up, a mark that these people are concerned? How are you sort of reading between the lines, so to speak, and figuring out if their stand actually does mean, it is a positive thing, if they really are walking the walk or walking the talk, so
yes,
to speak?
Yes, that's a very good question. Because we actually also look at their performance or mm-hmm. their environmental track
right.
record. Have they been involved in environment in projects that has been causing environmental destruction?
Mm-hmm.
What is their, if they have been legislators in the past, what are the bills that they have filed? And you know, we look at these
mm-hmm.
and we also look at how what they say mm-hmm. publicly.
Right.
Sometimes some of their we engage some of their staff and we, you know, sort of are able to gauge
right.
where they are really on
where
certain
they,
issues. And
stand.
We know that there are also, they are not really telling the whole truth
right.
in certain aspects.
Okay. Now, what are you, this year's, originally it was a forum that was, you know, you invited the senators to actually speak and debate maybe even and just lay out their platform.
Mm-hmm.
It's turned into a survey of sorts to find out what exactly their stand is. But what are we going to do with that information? Where can people find it? And how are people supposed to decipher what's like you said, true blue green, so to speak?
This afternoon we have a panel of environmental experts that mm-hmm. will be coming together to assess or review the contents of their responses.
Okay.
And then rate them accordingly. Mm-hmm. So by tomorrow, we will be releasing the results of this review. Okay. And then we will publish it. We will send it, of course, to media, and we will put it online for the social media.
Okay, so I think people who are concerned, and we all should be concerned, will be looking out for that information. I mean, Monday is right around the corner and elections, so I think we really should all choose wisely and put the environment at the forefront and choose wisely when it comes to Election Day. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Beau.
Thank you very much.